I love to be in the presence of the Holy Spirit. I know that I am not of this world, but I also know that I am in this world. And I know that my Father created this world, so I know that anything that's in this world, although I am not of this world, I can ask my Father for it and I can have it, and He will give it to me. But I say that to say this. When I'm in the presence of the Holy Spirit, it makes no difference how big the army is or that appears against me. If God be for me, who can be against me? It doesn't matter if there's 10,000 men that are against me. And I may stand alone, even though no man is an island. God is not a man, and He is not an island. So even though 10,000 men may stand against me, and my God is not a man, and He is not an island, therefore I do not stand alone, for I stand with God, and I stand my ground because I fear no man. And God will take up for me anytime man tries to take me down. God will take up. And I say that to say this, my brothers and my sisters. When you're in the presence of the Holy Spirit, you speak in a certain way. You act in a certain way. You do things in a certain way. For you feel the power within you coming out of you. But not coming out of you to come out of you per se, but coming out of you to empower somebody else, that they become empowered too. It's as if you were a battery hooked up to a charger, and all you were charged up so much that you had to have an outlet, and you began to charge up other people that were around you. And because they became charged, they became able to charge up other people that was around them. And so when the Lord decided to make a charge, He put you in charge and He told you to charge. And when you did charge, all the adversaries fell. They could not stand. And that's what I'm talking about, my brothers, when I say the Holy Spirit. For when you walk by faith and not by sight, you see in the faith that you walk in things that people cannot see in the sight that they see in. You see in faith that you walk in things that people cannot see in the sight that they see in. For those of you with sight lets you see what I just said in a pathetic way of speaking. For my God is a great God. He is a marvelous God. We serve a marvelous God. And He will not be denied. All that He says is coming to pass. Humble myself, I do. Humble yourself, you should. You have nothing to fight as far as fighting man in the flesh. For this is a spiritual warfare. And there is nothing to fight as far as fighting man in the flesh. And don't be so quick to want to accumulate, as I said, things of the Joneses, as if you got to keep up with them. You know, you don't have to always move on up in the wrong sense of moving up. Because sometimes some of us can move up, and in the process of us moving up, we may be moving ourselves out of our blessings. And we come to find out that we bit off more than we can chew, and that we now can't pay the car notes because we got the wrong type of car and it's too expensive. We can't pay the house note because we got the house too big and we can't keep up with the mortgage. And into where we could have had something to show if we had gotten a smaller car and if we had gotten a smaller house, we may have been able to pay our bills. And we would have had something to show because we would have had a car to drive in and we would have had a house to live in. But since we decided that we needed a bigger car than a bigger house, we could not keep up the car payment and we could not keep up the mortgage payment. So there was foreclosures on the house and repossession with repo of the car. And the next thing you know, we're barefooting once again. So my brothers and my sisters, you must be very careful. You don't need to keep up with anybody. You know what God put you here. If you learn what God put you here, use what God gave you. Your God-given gifts, what God's given you to be here for. And do that. Stop dressing up to impress people just so they can look at you to think that you are something. Because in reality, none of us are anything in the flesh. This flesh and blood body will go back to the ground. We're not. Don't worship people to be prestigious. When I go out, I do not worship people. You see, I know who my Father is, and I know what I'm capable of doing and what I'm not capable of doing. And I have enough people around me that are children of God. Whatever I can't do, there's someone else there that can do it. So you see, we are together and we work as one. No jealousy should exist if you're a child of God. No envy should exist if you're a child of God. So continue to be strong, my brothers and my sisters. Look at my videos. Hear the words that are being spoken from my mouth by the grace of God through the Holy Spirit. And get my books that I am putting out. For there is much strength within the words that are being spoken on the pages that are being written of the books that I am writing. Follow God, but listen to what you hear coming from me. May God be with you and thy grace be upon you all the days of your existence. Amen.